His Royal Majesty, His Royal Majesty, sir, Omoni Bua Edo. Omoni Edo. Oku Aponopono. Who are two? The Oba of Benin Kingdom.
Okay,
Ebani the second. Other members of this Royal Palace, Principal Staff Officers, General Staff Commanding 2 Division, Commander 4 Brigade, Senior Officers, Members of the Press List, and Gentlemen. His Royal Majesty, sir, I'm very pleased to be here this afternoon to pay my respect and homage to you, sir. Also get the royal blessing from this well-known, well-established kingdom. I came to 2 Division on operational visit, having assumed command like we had on 27 May 2021. You know the circumstances that brought me home with loss of our beloved to our Minister, Lieutenant General Ibrahim Atlahiru. May his soul rest in peace. It's usual, sir, after assuming command to go around your formation and units and see officers and men and have first-hand information and respect assessment and interact also with officers and soldiers, appreciate what they are doing and intervene when necessary and give guidance. And in doing that, when you visit a place, you cannot but must pay honor and respect to who and where it is due. That's why coming to Benin yesterday night, I deemed it necessary to come and pay my respect to you, sir. I have earlier been to His Excellency the Governor, and I'm here now to pay my respect to His Royal Majesty, not only that, but to thank you also and appreciate for all your efforts you are doing in this kingdom, in this great kingdom, to bring peace and security and ensure peaceful coexistence within the element that live here. And to thank and appreciate you for everything you are doing, and now request that Your Royal Majesty to please continue to do that, because we find that very, very important and essential in our operations. Incidentally, Your Royal Majesty, I was here when you came. I served in 4 Brigade. I was commander of 4 Brigade here 2015-2016. So I saw from that side your arrival. It's the first time I'm here in this capacity. I will say congratulations. It's never late to say congratulations. I'm also aware that we have new arrivals in the palace here. Of the wife here has given us what we have not seen for a very long time. At one time, quadruplet. Congratulations. Congratulations. Congratulations, and I thank you most sincerely for this warm reception you have accorded us. When you see the array of very senior palace officials that were arrayed for this event, you cannot but appreciate and thank you, sir, for this warm reception and kind gesture from you. Thank you so very much. We are most grateful.
sir.
I want to also thank you for your commendations, your encomiums that you kindly poured on us today. I cannot but also express condolences to him, to the army, to the loss of one of our great generals. We have here amongst us now distinguished generals of the Nigerian army. We can only pray to God and our ancestors to keep on preserving the lives of the military officers, keeping them out of harm's way. We know that professionally, it's like they are in contract to always be in harm's way, but all the same, we have to pray that they get back to their families in one piece. They say there's no hero that is a dead hero or something like that. So we always pray that you be celebrated heroes all the time. You get back whenever your operations, any operation in San Pista Forest, wherever it is, you come back to your families in one piece. And eventually retire to one piece. We'll keep on praying for our Nigerian army. Nigerian army is doing wonderful work for us. It's not easy to keep the peace. So it is also for the Nigerian Army, always work in progress. We also commend your efforts for the manner you've been ensuring peace in this very interesting country of ours. Very interesting. We also know that you take your responsibilities beyond borders. We know the role you have been playing in the entire region. We have an idea. We cannot say we know, but we have an idea. Having been a diplomat and served in different countries, we also got knowledge, information about the role Nigerian Army has been playing in particularly West African region, in ensuring peace in the West African sub-region. I want to appeal to the Nigerian Army not to relent in their efforts to ensure peace and tranquility, assisting the police, assisting other security agents in the country to maintain peace, which sometimes we see as elusive, becoming elusive, but Nigerian Army has been on top of the matter. Nobody is perfect, no agency is perfect, no organization is perfect. Not anywhere in the world, not even in the United States of America. Otherwise, you will not see the riots you saw in Washington, D.C. So we appreciate, I'm sure I say this on behalf of a lot of people, I don't say everybody appreciates good things or good work, but we do appreciate on behalf of a lot of people the good work the Nigerian Army has been doing. I want to thank you for coming. I know you came earlier, clashed with the visit of the IG. Incidentally was all over the place trying to also get familiar. Maybe the rain, the heavy rain also disturbed his movement. But we are here, we have been here since almost 4 or 5 hours now. We are here to welcome you, and we are delighted to
able to welcome gentlemen of the military, the command, the police command as well. So I thank you very much. We do our best here. You know, we have the brigade commander, you know, who we always interact with. As I always say, please, the palace of the Upper Menin is home to everybody. It's home to everybody. In uniform or outside uniform. Just take it once you have resumed duty here. Just feel confident when you think of the palace of the Oba of Benin. Think of it as your father's home, as your father's house. You can come in here anytime for anything. Whatever we can do, I have quite a few elders, you know, in here. That can advise, that I can send to assist, that can also advise me on what to do. We pray to God Almighty and our ancestors that we do not have the crisis in the kingdom, we don't have a crisis we cannot solve. There will always be conflict, but there's always a way to resolve conflict. It's a conflict resolution. That is the critical thing that we must worry about. Resolve conflicts peacefully, amicably, without shedding blood. I think they say the best, there's a saying in the military, the best general is one that can fight a battle without shooting a bullet. Did I say it correctly? That sort of thing. So we pray that the military keeps on maintaining peace, particularly if not necessarily in the Sapista Forest area, the terrorist area, at least in internal security to assist the police, without necessarily having to fire any bullets. Thank you very much for coming. I wish you well, congratulate you on your responsibilities, high responsibility. May it be well with you. May it be well with you, Chief of Army Staff. I want to thank you. I want to thank you specially for the gift you sent to me. So I wanted you to, I've been looking for what I sent a message to you at that time, but here you are. So I'm particularly happy to have you present in front of me. Thank you very much on behalf of my family. We hope we will see you not only officially like this, unofficially. When I'm in Abuja, I will endeavor to hold that for you. So I thank you very much. God bless you all, the officers of the Nigerian Army. God bless you all. May our ancestors be with you all the time.
Yes.
Go where you are coming from, those that are here. Peace of the Lord Almighty and our ancestors be with you all. Thank you very much. Thank you.
So if I have my word, I want to leave, but I have to. Let me, Your Royal Majesty, please have the privilege to present a plaque so that Your Royalness will remember that I was here one time. So it's my honor and privilege to on behalf of Nigerian and also a man to present this to the user.
Bala sopa!